Welcome and thank you. Welcome everyone to worship. We're so glad that you're here and those of you online as well. Let us know that you're here by liking or commenting. Good morning. Welcome to our guests. If you're looking for a church family, please reach out to one of the pastors or one of the leaders here and we'll be glad to answer your questions. We want to welcome Patrick Kerssen and his jazz trio today with Zach Martin and John Ventry. Is that right? Close? Okay, great. Thank you. We also want to thank our Funds of Lasting Gifts and the families who have created funds that allow us to fund opportunities like this for special music. Many of the songs that we're doing, we'll be joining and singing with them. You'll see that noted in the bulletin or on the slides. So you can watch Patrick and myself and we'll kind of help you know when to jump in and sing and also when to just enjoy the instrumental breaks. Please stay after worship today for some snacks and refreshments in the lobby and to visit one another. We want to thank God for this time and this space to worship and to remember just how loved we are.
Friends, join me in our call to worship. As we gather in this sacred moment for a sacred purpose, let us make the most of our time together. We have come to worship God and discover God's meaning and purpose for our lives. As we sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, let us make the most of our time together. We have come to worship God and discover God's meaning and purpose for our lives. As we respond to the melody in our hearts, let us make the most of our time together. We have come to worship God and discover God's meaning and purpose for our lives. Let us pray. Time slips away like water in the hand and a balloon lifted into the sky. We think there is plenty and then it is gone, wasted. So it is the will of God that we invest our time wisely in the divine work of worship. Today, we lift our voices and raise our hands, seeking to be filled with the Spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Stand in body or spirit to welcome each other. Here at Union, we say that no matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here. You are welcome here.
I'm gonna go this way.
Good morning.
I'll say good morning.
Good morning. Hi, glad. Thank you. Yeah. You may be seated. Kids, come on forward. All right, it's almost the end of summer. I'm thinking we should have this song mastered. Yeah. So the words are up there. So it's love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. All right, we're not going to do it that slow, though. Okay. The fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. The fruit of the Spirit's not a coconut. If you want to be a coconut, you want us all to hear it. You can't be a fruit of the Spirit, because the fruit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. All right, we'll do the chorus one more time, but a little bit slower. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faith. Don't watch me. Faith, gentleness, self-control. I'm watching you, and you're watching me. Look at Paige's back. Woo! All right, go ahead and go with Miss Tiffany to children's time. That's a workout, man.
Today we'll hear the same scripture, but from two different translations. The first translation of Ephesians 5, verses 11 to 20, is from the New Revised Standard Version. You can follow along with the Bible in the rack in front of you on page 194 in the New Testament. Hear this letter to the people of Ephesus and to us. Take no part in the unfruitful works of darkness, but instead expose them. For it is shameful even to mention what such people do secretly, but everything exposed by the light becomes visible, for everything that becomes visible is light. Therefore it says, sleeper, awake, rise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you. Be careful then how you live, not as unwise people, but as wise, making the most of the time, because the days are evil. So do not be foolish, but understand what the will of the Lord is. Do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit as you sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs among yourselves, singing and making melody to the Lord in your hearts, giving thanks to God the Father at all times and for everything in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. The second translation of this Ephesians passage is from the Message. Don't waste your time on useless work, mere busy work, the barren pursuits of darkness. Expose these things for the sham they are. It's a scandal when people waste their lives on things they must do in the darkness where no one will see. Rip the cover off those frauds and see how attractive they look in the light of Christ. Wake up from your sleep. Climb out of your coffins. Christ will show you the light. So watch your step. Use your head. Make the most of every chance you get. These are desperate times. Don't live carelessly, unthinkingly. Make sure you understand what the Master wants. Don't drink too much wine. That cheapens your life. Drink the Spirit of God, huge drafts of Him. Sing hymns instead of drinking songs. Sing songs from your heart to Christ. Sing praises over everything. Any excuse for a song to God the Father in the name of our Master, Jesus Christ. This is the end of readings today. Our response we are singing is also a prayer. May God's word be a lamp for our feet and a light for our path.
Thank you. Thank you. Children praying, Lord, send your spirit to this place. Lord,
Can everybody hear when I'm singing into the? I'm trying to help out by actually singing. All right, cool. I'm just making sure. I apologize for singing. You know, I'm a piano player, but we're doing what we can. All right, here we go. Let's see. Just the last four. My brain isn't functioning.
A friend we have in trials and tribulations. Is there trouble anywhere?
There's a pastoral prayer first. We're going to the beach.
I was all sorts of confused. Friends, let's be in a time of prayer. Holy God, you have heard our joyful worship to you this morning. You've heard it in the sounds of the drums and the bass and the piano, in the lifting of our voices, and the joy that we are all experiencing. We thank you, God, for this opportunity to be gathered here in your loving presence and to take in this joyful day and joyful music. We know, God, that you are with us through all of the pains of life, both the physical pains, the emotional pains, and the pains that we don't ever say out loud. We ask that you be with all of those who we list and all of those who we love who are experiencing medical issues, mental health issues, just issues of soul and life, and those who just need a little bit extra love from you, oh God. Through this summer, we've been praising you with flowers and hearts, and today we lift up to your life, Pastor Kaylee, and kids, and we pray for mental health, and for Maureen, and for a healthy baby, and Barb, and for help to grow, for Pastor Chris, for healing for Dan's mom. We pray for Paige and our consistory and our family friends and Deb, and for God and that we see in the faces of grandbabies. We pray for a son and daughter and for all of the children here at Union UCC. We pray for all the missions and for the wilderness. We pray for Pastor Carrie and Brooke. We pray for baby Owen Evans and their family. We pray for love. We pray for Nan and for Pamela and for family. God, we pray for Travis and for peace and for Hayden. We pray for a cat and for friends and for Rhett. We pray for our leadership planning team and for Lisa. We pray for Sandy and this church. We pray for peace. We pray for the end of gun violence. We pray for those children who are hungry. We pray for Mary and for the lovely grove that we have to experience in your love in. We pray for family and friends, for Abby, for healing, for Trisha, and for JS, and we pray for all of us. And we pray these things, O God, in your holy name and the way your Son taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was blind, but now I am found, was blind, but now I see. Through many a choice and snares that save.
Next Sunday, friends, worship will be at 10:30 outside in the Grove, and that will be our final Grove worship service for the summer. Hopefully the weather will be beautiful and we'll have another wonderful day of worship in our Grove. Thanks to everyone who has been bringing donations of socks and underwear to support local shelters, and we are also now collecting school supplies through the end of September, which will be given to local agencies to help children who need some extra help with some school supplies. Sunday school for all of our youth and children will start on September 8th, and the start of Children's Church will be September 15th. There will be a little bit of a hiatus the next couple weeks for the children's time, but it will start again on September 15th. The youth advisory team will be starting to form as we get into our fall program year. That's the word I was looking for, program year. And our first lunch will be October 13th. We're excited about that. Same with high school happy hour starting up again in October, as well as our open Sunday school. And back by popular demand, at the end of September, we will be hosting our baked potato lunch fundraiser for the youth group. I heard some whoop whoops. So please be on the lookout for some information about that and how to purchase tickets, and join us on September 29th for a delicious lunch of baked potatoes with all of the toppings you can even imagine, hopefully. I'm gonna blame Eric for that one. Confirmation class is forming. Any children or any youth that are eighth grade or older who have not yet been confirmed are invited to join us, with orientation being on September 22nd. Pastor Carrie still has room in her grief share group, which starts August 29th. So if you are looking for something to help you, if you are grieving, please be sure to check that out. And the event that was being held with the Lutheran Church that was supposed to be held next Sunday is now being held on October 6th. September brings a lot of stuff going on here. It brings back Faith on Tap and Zoom meditation, and a chance to walk our labyrinth on September 14th. We'll have Breathe back in October, and God First Wednesdays will also return with a new idea this year in October, and it's gonna be called Wednesday Nights at Union. So join us on God First Wednesday, and then stick around for the rest of the month on Wednesdays. Our first monthly series in October will be on the TV series, I'm gonna call it a TV series, that's what it is, The Chosen. So you get to come hear me talk about that, because it'll be a good time. Blues Night Out is next Saturday, the 24th, so come out for music and food. There's a Family Promise fundraiser, a sip and mingle, on September 4th. And Family Promise, we are hosting a week again here in September, and we're always looking for new and regular volunteers. So if you are looking to get interested in that and volunteer, please see the information in your bulletin.
Our open and affirming team has been formed, and Eric Minnick's here to talk about it.
Good morning, everyone. Come to you today to speak about the opening affirming committee and update you on what we've been working on. As I'm sure you know, our status as an open and affirming congregation was approved earlier this year at the national level. To receive this designation, we entered into a covenant with the United Church of Christ Open and Affirming Coalition that we will commit ourselves as a congregation to not only welcome all into the life and ministry of our church, but to be the light for those people who have been kept in the dark and not welcomed into the life of the church. In 1961, Roger Maris became the single season home run champion, hitting 61 home runs in 162 games, beating Babe Ruth's record by one. Maris's new record was denoted with an asterisk because his record was set in 162 games, as opposed to Babe Ruth's, who was set in 154 games. The asterisk kind of represented an exception. I've been involved here for a long time. Sunday school confirmation, just like many of you, I'm deeply familiar with the stories and the teachings and the parables of Jesus. One that sticks out to me is from Mark chapter 12. Jesus is asked, which of these commandments is the greatest? He replies, to love the Lord your God with all your heart and all your soul, with all your mind and all your strength. And he tells us to love our neighbors as we love ourselves. I did some research and I looked at a few different versions of the Bible, and there's no asterisk. Or more simply put, there's no exceptions listed. It doesn't say love your neighbor as long as love your neighbor as yourself, as long as they come to Union UCC, or as long as they have the same skin color as you, or love them as long as they're straight. He tells us to love our neighbors, all of them, as we love ourselves. No asterisks, no exceptions. These, Jesus tells us, are the two greatest commandments. This afternoon, members of the Open and Affirming Committee will be attending Lehigh Valley Pride at the Steel Stacks and representing the Penn Northeast Conference. We'll be there from 5 to 7. Pack an umbrella, a poncho, come visit us. Come show all our neighbors, gay, straight, trans, old, young, white, black, Hispanic, whoever, all our neighbors, the love that awaits them in a congregation just like ours. We will continue to be the voice for those who some choose to ignore, for those who cannot speak for themselves, and for those who cannot be heard. Thank you.
Heck yeah.
I'm a little verklempt because Eric was one of my youth, one of our youth when I first came here a billion years ago, and yeah, that's pretty
she
awesome.
She called you old.
So for 3 weeks, August 25th, September 1 and 8, kids and all students and teachers, everyone in education, all personnel, you are welcome to bring your backpacks, your laptops, your tablets, your pens or pencils, whatever you want, your lunchbox, or just yourself, and we will bless you as you begin a new school year, a new semester. So we're excited about that. We also want to congratulate Jake Pua and Sarah Alexander. They were married yesterday. That's Jake is Marianne and Ralph Pua's son. So we send them our love and blessings and congratulations. You see their flower Post-it notes are still up front here. You are welcome to continue to share your prayers for where you see God's love blooming or where you're praying for God's love to bloom. And so now we move into a time of offering. Freely we have received, so we give freely, grace upon grace. Let's express our love and appreciation to God by extending the grace and mercy of God to a hungry world. Thank you. Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. We bow before you and thank you for the privilege to participate in your acts of kindness and love here on earth. May these gifts truly become instruments of your purposes here in our church, our community, and around the world. Amen. Filled to the brim with the goodness of God, the nourishment of Jesus Christ, the bread of life, and the power of the Holy Spirit, go now in peace to serve God in all that you think, do, and say. God's peace and presence will always be with you. Amen.
We'll be right back. Thank you.